Hello, busy dads and busy people everywhere. If you're new to this channel, welcome. This is the channel all about the Busy Dad program. The Busy Dad program, my friends, is the remarkably simple, effective, and time-efficient training protocol that I've been following for the past 2.5 years, week in, week out, since my daughter was born. It's gotten me into the best shape of my life. And my friends, the crazy part about this whole approach is it only demands 80 minutes out of your week. Not your day, but your week. There was a time when I trained 80 minutes a day. And after 2.5 years of training 80 minutes a week, I'm in the best shape of my life. And I'm only getting fitter and getting stronger. If you're curious about this life-changing training protocol, please check out this channel, like and subscribe, and head on over to busydadtraining.com, which gives you a crystal clear breakdown of the whole program and tells you exactly how to get started yourself. So my friends, the Busy Dad program is all about consistency. It's about cultivating a practice, and that means showing up whether you want to or not. And for some reason today, I really don't want to. It's Tuesday. Usually I train on a Monday, but yesterday was 4th of July. I took it with the family. And now I feel like I kind of missed the bus. I feel like this week's already underway and I haven't got into it. And I've built up a resistance. I took 3 consecutive rest days. It might have been 4. And the last workout that I did wasn't super taxing. I feel a little bit far away from my practice, a little bit intimidated. When that happens, of course, the first thing of real importance is that you just get back in. I've been debating with myself about what kind of workout to do. I've decided that a good way of building back into my practice will be to do the new JC challenge that JC came up with last week. So for those of you who don't know, the new JC challenge, JC is our man who gives us challenges every so often, is for 20 minutes to move between 10 six counts and 10 squats and see how many sets you can rack up. I've decided that the way I'm going to structure this week of training is today, I'm going to go weightless for the challenge. No weighted vest like I've been usually using. The next 2 sessions of the week will be standard Busy Dad Program 2.0 six count and Navy SEAL sessions. And then at the end of the week, I'll redo the challenge, but this time with the vest. But today I'm setting a weight-free benchmark. So let's see what we can do. So it's kind of great not to be putting on the vest today. And also disorienting. Anyway. My strategy is going to be similar to one that I've often used, which is to forget the clock exists until I hit a certain benchmark, and then to consult the clock to strategize for the rest of the workout. So I'm going to go 12 rounds as quickly as I possibly can. Of course, this is a challenge for time. And once I'm at 12, I'm going to take a look at the clock and make a plan to see what I can do for the rest of the workout. We're still feeling the waters. Definitely want to go above 20 if I possibly can. Beyond that, I don't know what to aim for. So let's give this one a shot. Think that we're filming. Yeah, we are.
One round down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 2 hours, down, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 3 hours down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 4 hours down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 5 hours. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's 6. I believe. Hope. 7. Two, three, four. 5, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 1, 2, 3, 5, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 7, 8, 9, 10, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 5, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Thirteen. 14. That was 16. 18. Ten, that was 19. Two, three, four, five, eight. One, two, three, four, five. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Three rounds. 10. That's 21. Last one. 10. Right, three rounds. That's 230. 6 counts, 230 squats, 20 minutes of work. It's hellfire for the lower body. You can't work out whether it's the 6 count or the squat that's the rest, and then you realize there is no rest. They just hurt in different ways. And eventually the two pain streams converge. And by about minute 15, you're holding on for dear life. It's a great workout, my friends, a real keeper. No surprise, given that it came from the mind of JC. Strongly recommend you try it out. All those 6 count maestros in the community, Toe Nerve, James Bruce, still in the game, Body by Burpees. I'd love to see you guys trying this out. I'm especially excited to see Tony from Still in the Game give this a try, given his complete mastery over the bodyweight squat. I think he could be hitting at least 25. It felt good to take the vest off, but I'm also looking forward to getting that old friend back on my shoulders from tomorrow. Thanks for all your support as ever, my friends.
And if you're new to the channel, join us. Take care.